Look, you can't make us think something's happened to Nora. She's gone. I know she has. She wanted to go.
You leave her alone! Just about had enough of you two. And I want to make something very clear to all of you. Anyone doesn't do what I say, when I say it, is going to find themselves on the missing list with Flynn. You get me?
Bastards.
It's the wedding, remember? Our wedding.
What do they think they're doing here?
They're not locals. I don't know what they're trying to accomplish.
That emblem look familiar to you?
Yes, it does. Rita Connors.
I have tried so hard to get through to those women that if there's a way of causing trouble, they'll always find it. Now that Kelly's taken over as top dog, there'll be no way of getting through.
What is it? David...
No, stop. Stop where you are.
Oh, it's all right, Eve. I'm not going to hurt you. It'll live with what you've done.
Why did he do it?
Didn't he say anything?
No. Suddenly he had a gun. I thought for a minute he was going to kill me.
I should never have let him in without searching him. But he was a friend of Mr. Fulbright's and Mrs. Reynolds too, if it comes to that.
The police? They're going to ask questions. I can't tell them anything. I barely knew him. He was just my lawyer.
No one is going to blame you.
He must have been in a lot of trouble. Perhaps he was embezzling money and thought that they'd find out.
If it's anything like that, we'll know about it soon enough.
His wife, he said that she left him...
Don't talk about it! As soon as we can, I'll get you to the infirmary and Sister will give you something.
Please, I have to tell somebody. When I first met him, he said that I reminded him of his wife. Maybe, if he was disturbed, well, in his confusion, perhaps he thought he was trying to hurt her.
It's no good going on thinking about it. We'll probably never know the real reason.
No. No, I suppose not.
I'll see your IDs, hello? Please.
Sorry, that's not possible at this time of night.
Yeah, well, they seem to be in order. Now, do you want to go through or do you want to talk to the governor first? She should be here soon.
Oh, we can manage that. Would you mind taking us through?
Right, Officer Radcliffe, show the officers through and get the women back to their cells.
Well, they're still on rec period.
Tell them it's early lock-up and don't tell them why.
We want to speak to the officer who found the body, too.
I'll take you to her.
Forensic will be here in a minute. Show them straight through.
Right.
How did this happen?
Did they tell you on the phone?
Most of it. I want to know how he got in with a gun.
You'll have to ask Slattery that. She was the one who showed him through.
Anyone know why he did it?
If they do, they're not saying. Maybe this will tell you something.
Where did this come from?
He gave it to Slattery on the way in.
Did you tell the police?
Ah, it's addressed to you.
Yeah, well, it's not lock up for another 10 minutes, so what do we have
because
to go...
I'm telling you to.
Yeah, well, we've got a right to know why. Yeah, well, I told you I heard something before, but you all reckon I was imagining things.
Jacko said a police car and an ambulance came a little while ago.
Look, I'm not going to stand here talking all night. Now start moving.
Well, no point making an issue of it. We'll find out soon enough.
What about Eve Wilder? Pretty funny she went to see her solicitor so late, and she isn't even back yet.
Yeah, well, something bloody's going on, and we're not moving till we find out what it is.
Yeah, we got our rights.
Anyone not back in their cell within 2 minutes flatters on a charge.
Big deal. We'll find out anyway.
Feeling a little better, are we?
Oh, Miss Ferguson. Oh, it was horrible. He got the gun.
I'm surprised Sister didn't keep you in the infirmary overnight.
Oh, she did suggest it, but I couldn't sleep there, not after what had happened.
Oh, I don't think it's over yet, Wilder.
If the police know what happened, I think I'd like to know.
Would you? Well, if you ask nicely, perhaps the governor will let you read the letter that he left for her. It explained everything.
Letter?
Hmm. But then you might have to stand in line. I understand the police are also very interested.
What letter? What did it say?
Nothing you don't already know. Come on, I'm moving you to solitary.
No, wait. I have to talk to somebody. Another solicitor.
Oh, you'll get your chance. If you can find one. And after what happened to the first one, I don't think they'll be exactly queuing up, do you? Come on.
Bastard. Spineless bastard.
No one is allowed in without their personal effects being searched. You know that. Do you know it or don't you?
Yes.
Then why didn't you?
I don't know. It was late. Wasn't going to let him in at all.
That's hardly an excuse.
It's only because of you I let him in.
What do you mean?
Well, he's a friend of your family's. He couldn't come any earlier because he'd been at your daughter's wedding.
What's that got to do with anything?
Well, supposing he had needed to see Eve Wilder on urgent business and I hadn't let him in, what would you have thought then? Look, all I'm trying to say is you can't always go by the book. You have to try and think what people really would want you to do. And it's not easy. Next thing I know, I'll be blamed for Collins getting killed.
Yes, well, perhaps I can understand you letting him through without a proper check.
What's going to happen now?
First priority's Keane. She's the one who suffered most from this. Apart from David, and he seems to have brought most of it on himself. I've already phoned Dr. Weissman. Chances are she'll be released first thing in the morning. So we can at least give her that bit of good news and get her out of solitary. Let's do it now.
You bitch, Ferguson! I want us to listen and now! You bitch!
You going to put her back in with the other women?
No, I don't want them comparing notes. We'll move her into isolation.
Does Pippa know yet about David Adams?
It's only ruined the honeymoon. God knows they deserve something after the mess those bikies made of the wedding.
It's all right, don't get up.
Yeah, so what's going on now? Where are they sending me?
We're not sending you anywhere. Rebecca, we now know you didn't do it. I'm sorry you had to go through this. I can't promise anything except to say that I'll do everything in my power to see that you're released as soon as possible. Tomorrow, I hope.
I know it's late, but I've been
enough, Connors.
Not bloody quietly. I've got a complaint. Save you a lot of trouble if you talk to me now. You hear me, Mrs. Governor?
Open it. Are you sure? She's a rat.
I know what she is. Open it.
I want you to know somebody is going to pay for this.
Is that right? And I suppose you think you're going to get clean away with what happened at my daughter's wedding this afternoon.
Well, yeah, what was that?
Spare me the innocent act. I don't know how you got word out to your friends, but they certainly didn't turn up there by coincidence.
You mean... What do you know, good old slasher? Turned out to pay his respects, did he?
It's always a way with people like you, isn't it? You're never happy unless you're making someone miserable.
Is that so?
It was the most important day in those people's lives, but your low-level friends had to do their level best to ruin it for them.
And I bet their best was pretty good, eh? Well, maybe it might have taught that jumped-up kid of yours a lesson. I just wish I'd been there to see the look on her face. Hey, but what about me jacket? I want you to know whoever did it's going to wish they were dead. You can tell them that from me.
I have to admire your self-control. No one could have blamed you if you'd clouted her one.
What happened to Ben and Pippa this afternoon happened because I'm governor, but because I'm governor, I can't fight back. Can you see the fairness in that?
I don't know. I suppose it's just that kind of a job.
It certainly is.
I don't know what this place is turning into. I really don't. It's just one thing after another, and frankly, I have had enough.
I'll be taking steps to see it doesn't happen again.
Do you have the faintest idea how all this is going to reflect on me when I have to stand up and start answering questions in the House?
You'll just have to say that I've accepted full responsibility. May Collins was aware of the risk and took the decision on her own behalf. As far as what happened last night's concerned, security will be tightened. And as for Flynn's disappearance, we'll just have to hope we find her. I understand the police have Willie Beecham under surveillance in case she tries to contact her.
Yes, well, you'll excuse me if I don't find any of that very reassuring. Obviously, a major change in administrative policy is called for. Now, I'm putting this to you officially. You get this place back on the rails fast, or else...
Or else what?
Or else I may have to reconsider whether you are, in fact, competent to hold the governorship here. I don't care what you do or how you do it, but I want the lid on this place. I want it kept out of the papers and out of the public eye. I can't see that it should be all that difficult.
Come in.
Sorry to interrupt, Mrs. Reynolds, but you did say to tell you when Keane was ready to leave.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, don't bring her in here. I'll be there to see her shortly.
Yes, why don't you go and do that? I'll wait here. I have some time to kill before my next appointment. I'd appreciate a cup of tea.
Of course. I'll have one sent in to you. It shouldn't be long.
I still can't believe it was Eve did that to Mrs. Barry. How could anybody seem so nice and end up being so rotten?
Just goes to show you can't trust no one, eh, children?
Tried to tell you, but none of yous would listen.
And then putting the blame on poor old Reb like that.
I mean about her being a two-faced bitch.
Yeah. Tell you something else. If I was keen, I'd be hiring myself a damn good lawyer and sue their bloody heads off, eh?
I don't know. She didn't seem too upset when we saw her this morning. Was glad to be getting out, I reckon. Mm. Anyway, nobody else saw through it. Why blame Mrs. Reynolds?
Because it's her job. Bloody mess she's made of it. Yeah, who was it got May Collins killed, eh?
Oh, yeah, the bloody bitch. We don't know we got all the facts. It mightn't really have been her fault.
Of course it's her bloody fault. And we're going to get rid of her, right? Yeah, get rid of her.
But look at what she's done for us in the past. We could end up with somebody much worse.
Oh, listen to the teacher's pet.
It's not that. I just don't think we're being very fair.
No one cares what you think, wimpface. And shut it or you have a lot more to worry about than your precious Mrs. Reynolds.
All things considered, there's not much I can say except to wish you luck and say again how sorry I am for what happened to you at Blackmore. And for the events of the past couple of days here.
Yeah, I'm just glad to be getting out, that's all.
There's one thing I want you to promise me, that you'll stay in contact with Dr. Wiseman. If you need any help making the adjustment, I'm sure he can give it to you.
You mean keep an eye on me in case I look like flipping out again?
No, that's not what I meant. If you feel you're getting confused again, obviously he'll be able to help with that too. The most important thing is to keep in touch with
him. Yeah, I will. Don't worry, Mrs. Reynolds. It's going to be hard to make friends out there.
Everyone feels like that when they leave here, but you'll make new friends soon enough.
Yeah, you everything. Oh, look, I know it's a chance to start over, and I am going to make the best of it. Well, thanks for everything you've done for me.
I'm afraid it wasn't as much as it could have been.
Oh, well, at least you believed in me. Except for that business with Mrs. Barry. I guess I can't blame you for that. I suppose I'll always wonder what would have happened if that bloke hadn't left a note.
I'd like to think we would have got to the truth eventually. Anyway, good luck.
Oh, yeah. Good luck to you, Mrs. Reynolds.
And don't forget, you've got an appointment with Dr. Wiseman later on in the day.
Yeah, don't worry. I won't forget anything. Not this time.
Come in.
Eve Wilder's still waiting to see you, Governor.
Bring her in.
Come on.
I've come to see why I haven't been allowed to see a solicitor.
No one's stopping you.
Then why hasn't one been to see me?
We've been having trouble finding someone who's willing to represent you.
I wonder how hard you've tried. I'm entitled to a solicitor, and it's up to you to get me one. I know my rights.
You're unbelievable, Wilder.
What about David Adams' rights?
It's got nothing to do with it, and you know that. The fact is, I'm entitled to a solicitor.
You really don't give a damn, do you?
You couldn't care less how many people you've destroyed.
Why should I? Men come to me, I don't go to them. Why should I feel guilty?
By the same reasoning, you won't expect any sympathy for the situation you're in now.
I don't want sympathy. I want my rights. Get me a solicitor.
I've contacted Legal Aid and someone's on their way here now.
Legal Aid? Some long-haired kid who's never defended anything bigger than a TV repossession? I'm not a welfare case. I can afford the best available...
What you can afford doesn't come into it. In fact, I understand even legal aid had trouble finding someone to take you on. What you've got to realize is that David Adams had a lot of friends. You don't have any at all.
Joyce? Joyce?
Irvin?
I'm here, love.
Irvin, is that you?
Oh, thank God. Yes, it's me. Everything's going to be all right now. Everything's going to be fine.
What's happened to me? I can't see you.
Nothing to worry about. It's only your eyes. The doctor said they'd take a little time to get back to normal.
My eyes. What's happened to my eyes? Everything's all blurry.
Look, it's only temporary. I'd better call the doctor. He'll want to see you.
What's happened to me, Mervyn? I should be at work. Who's doing my shift?
Don't worry about things like that. You've been hurt, but you're going to be all right now. Wait till the doctor gets here and he'll tell you all about it.
There must be something you can tell me about the solicitor.
It was arranged on very short notice. I don't know any more about it than you do. Except that it's someone from Legal Aid.
Yeah, I already know that. Mrs. Reynolds took great pleasure in telling me that no one else would handle the case. I wonder how hard she really tried to find someone.
Some of these legal aid people are very good, and you can think yourself lucky you've got anybody at all.
We'll see about that. I'll have him eating out of my hands in 2 minutes flat. You ought to stick around, you might learn something.
In you go.
I'm Amanda Francis, the new solicitor.
The last thing I remember is seeing him out of the prison. Oh, how could anyone do such a terrible thing?
I know it's hard to believe, but it was all on a note he left Mrs. Reynolds. He just must have been completely in her power, but some part of his mind was still clear enough to see how hopeless it was.
It seems incredible that she could fool us all like that. I know she's attractive, but why would people let her take over their lives and destroy them like that?
I don't have much to do with it, but yes, there is something about her.
Oh, I feel as though it's partly my fault. Oh,
don't be silly, love. How could it be?
When I first heard those sounds coming from the interview room, I knew something unprofessional was happening, but... oh, I was too embarrassed. If only I'd looked into it then and there, we might have stopped it before it was too late.
I think it was already too late. But there's nothing you or anyone could have done, love. The only person to blame is Eve Wilder, and she's getting what's coming to her now.
Mervyn? Hmm? What's this on my finger?
Oh, I put it there. It's a little present.
But a ring. Mervyn?
Yes, well, when I saw you lying there, I was terrified I was going to lose you. It's an engagement ring. You can take it off. I'd understand.
Oh, Mervyn, you've been so patient with me. I don't deserve you. I really don't.
You mean you'll wear it? You'll marry me?
One thing all this has made me realize, life is too precious not to take the chance of happiness when it comes. I'd love to marry you, Mervyn. I really would more than anything else on earth.
Oh, you'll never be sorry, Joyce. You won't.
I know.
Oh, Joyce.
I know.
But you must believe I didn't want to do those awful things. I didn't really know what I was doing. I was driven to it.
Not according to the information I've got, which is also available to the prosecution, of course. I presume you've been informed of the extra charges you're now facing? Murder, attempted murder, occasioning grievous bodily harm, conspiracy to murder. And there may even be one or two others I don't even know about yet.
But surely the extenuating circumstances...
Nothing you've told me suggests there are any extenuating circumstances. Oh, maybe you can convince the jury otherwise, but I doubt it. My professional advice is that you have two options. You can plead not guilty and leave it to the Crown to establish guilt, or you can plead guilty. And it's just possible the judge might take that into account when sentencing. Personally, I doubt it. I think you'll be doing very well not to get life. The best advice I can give you is you better start getting used to that idea.
Where are you going?
Back to the laundry. I've just been to the toot, if that's all right.
Get a move on.
Hey, that bloke really put one over on you last night. Made a beaut mess of your nice clean interview room, didn't he?
Getting a bit big for your boots, Kelly. This top dog garbage is going to your head.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah. You've got to be careful someone doesn't make a mess of you.
Who? You?
Oh, why would I bother? It'd only be a matter of letting Connors know who did over that jacket of hers.
I can handle her.
Oh, she'd have you in a minute and bounce you off the walls. But don't worry. It suits me to have you as top dog for the moment.
Well, it's nice of you. Glad you appreciate talent.
Don't kid yourself. Having someone as gutless as you in charge makes my job a whole lot easier.
Oh! Get more laughs in a morgue than round here today.
It's not the same without May and Willie, is it?
Yeah. Hey, one of those dingbats that brighten the place up a bit.
Patterson, out here.
What?
Out here.
What do you want?
I want you to do me a little favour. Get yourself put on trade duty at lunch. And I want you to tell Connors it was the freak who poured paint all over her jacket.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
Tell her you saw it.
No way. The freak would kill me if she found out.
What do you think I'll do to you if you don't? Get out and don't touch me. Or I'll tell Wheeler it was you. How are you going to prove it?
Don't think I'd have to prove it, do you? I just suggest it. You go from top dog to dog mate in 2 seconds.
Right. I'll do you a deal. You do this for me. And I'll give you that $100 I owe you.
You already owe me that money. Why should I do anything else for it?
Because if you don't, you'll be too sore to move.
Yeah, all right. But if you don't pay up this time, I'll...
Do you want your money or don't you?
I want it.
All right, then. You do this for me and you'll get it.
Then we can all have fun watching the freaking Connors trying to rip each other's heads off.
After that, you can talk to anyone you like about it. That is, if there's anyone left to talk to.
As you know, I had the minister here this morning. He's far from impressed by our recent performance. I have to take responsibility for that, and each one of you has to share it.
Got nothing to do with me.
It has to do with everyone who works in this prison. All right, maybe there was some small excuse for what happened last night. It was the last thing anyone could have expected. But where was everyone when Joyce Barry was being attacked? Where were we when Nora Flynn decided to escape? There is simply no excuse for such things to happen. I'm sorry, I don't mean to imply that any single person is responsible. What I am trying to say is that as a group, collectively, we sometimes tend to lose sight of the tremendous responsibility we have here, and we quite simply cannot afford to do that.
Well, for what it's worth, I happen to agree with the governor. Well, just look at the way Beecham and Collins were allowed to escape. Now, Collins is dead. Not that that's any great loss as far as I'm concerned, but the public might see it as a reflection on the department and therefore on us. Is that the sort of thing you meant, Governor?
I think I made it quite clear what I meant. I'll be putting out a memo for security to be tightened in all areas. Please read it. That's all. Thank you for your time.
It's supposed to stick holes in them.
What?
The sausages. It's supposed to stick holes in them so the internal pressure doesn't burst the skin.
Listen, this is the way I do it, right? I like to watch the inside burst and spill all over the hot plate.
I think I'll just have salad.
Everyone got enough to eat?
Yeah.
Yeah, gotta look after me girls, eh? Yeah. Get yourself around that. Meat on your skinny bones. Who else wants a snack?
Miss Ferguson, is there any word on Mrs. Barry?
Not that I know of. Now get on with your food and stop all this nonsense. Come on, Kelly, I want to talk to you. Over here. Come on, move.
What's the hassle? We're just having a bit of fun.
Give me fun in a minute. Now, come on, move. Well, what is it? Well, something I want you to do for me.
Oh, yeah, and who says I want to?
Tell me I didn't hear that, Kelly. Tell me it was a joke. Right, what do you want? I want you to keep the women stirred up about what happened to Beecher and Collins.
Why?
Never mind why. Just do it. And then we'll get rid of someone that neither of us likes very much.
In you go.
Something I've got to tell you. They're going to get you for what you did to Joyce and Reb.
Come on, get a move on.
Thank you.
This better be good. Otherwise, I might have to have a word to the cook.
Oh, might have trouble finding out who it was. We all let her go. Probably be dead of food poisoning by tonight.
Patterson, how many times do I have to tell you? No talking. Now move out or you won't be going outside for your own lunch.
Get him inside.
Come on, you lot, start moving. Inside.
Yeah, we're not going.
You what?
Well, I've been asked as top dog to say we're having a protest.
Protest about what?
About the mess everything's in. Yeah. Especially about May Collins being killed.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't be ridiculous, Kelly. Come on, let's have you all back inside.
Now, come on, let me get this straight. Am I to understand that you were protesting about the governor's handling of the Willie Beecham-May Collins affair?
Yeah.
And I suppose you expect a formal apology and an assurance from the governor that it won't happen again.
Yeah. And we want more rec time.
Oh, yeah, and that tap in the shower fixed.
Yeah, and
don't we're push your luck, Kelly. Now, all I can do is convey your grievance to the governor. Of course, in the meantime, if you wish to continue this protest, that is your prerogative.
Yeah, we do.
Isn't this just going to make it harder for Mrs. Reynolds?
Well, why shouldn't we?
She's already apologised. It wasn't her fault. And when she tried to talk to us about it, we wouldn't listen.
Egbert, shut up.
Yeah, but don't you see? If we want a discussion with Mrs. Reynolds, all we have to do is ask. You can sit out here all night, you'll achieve nothing.
Yeah, well, what if we just get Reno mad and they lock us out? We've already eaten all the food.
Oh, look, it's a waste of time. I'm freezing. I'm going back inside. Anybody else?
Yeah. Hey, you lot, get back here.
Hey, look, she might be right. Well, what's the point? TV says it's going to rain all night.
What's that got to do with it?
A lot if we're stuck out here. I'm going back in.
That was close. Thank God Egbert spoke up.
Yes, I'll remember it.
This isn't going to make us late, is it?
No, no, it's all right. We've got some time yet.
Just had to sit down for a minute. I'm shaking all over.
No need to be nervous about Stevens. He's one of the best doctors I know to take over your therapy. You'll get along just fine, I know.
Yeah, well, it's not that. It's the way I feel scares me. It's like I'm turning back to what I was.
In what way?
Well, when I found out that it was Eve Wilder who had me blamed for bashing Mrs. Barry, I wanted to get her. I'd have really hurt her, I think, if I had the chance.
And that worries you?
Well, yeah.
Good. Because when it doesn't, you've really got something to worry about. When someone intentionally hurts us, it's only normal that we want to try and hit back at them. As it is living in a civilized society, we've got to learn to control those feelings. Some of us can, others can't. That's the big difference between the way you were and the way you are now. The old Reb couldn't control those feelings, didn't even try. The new Reb can. Does that make it easier?
Yeah, I suppose. A bit.
Good.
Hell of a big world out there.
Einstein. You won any Nobel Prizes yet?
I suppose Mum's home.
Oh, she's bloody home. Where else is she likely to be? She's feeling a bit crook this morning. Hey, I just had a call from your brother.
Yeah? Reverse charges, was it?
Don't you get bloody smart with me, son. No, he's got himself a good job now. More than you're likely ever to do. Up on a cane farm in Queensland. Real man's work. Not that you know what that is.
Yeah, well, let's hope he keeps this job a bit longer than the last one.
Mum!
Oh, in here, love.
I wasn't expecting you today.
Oh. I know. But I had some spare time today, so I just thought I'd see how you were. Do you want a cuppa?
Oh, don't bother. I'll do it.
Oh, not again.
Oh, I'd forgotten all about that, and there's nothing.
What was it this time?
Don't worry about it. It's nothing serious.
It never is with him. How much longer are you going to put up with it?
Honestly, Peter, it doesn't bother me anymore. Well, it's a little bit harder now you're not living at home, but at least it looks as if Harry's going to be away for a while, so I suppose it more or less evens things out.
Hmm. Yeah, big man on a cane farm now, I gather, huh? Mm.
Well, it's a job. Your father's happy about it.
We all know what a great authority he is on career opportunities.
Now, don't you start anything, hmm? Come on, let's put the kettle on.
Hardly said a word. Are you all right?
Oh, yes. Just tired.
It's funny how hospitals do that, too. At least the doctor said Joyce is out of danger now.
It's about the one thing I can be thankful for. I don't know. Must be getting old. Just don't seem to be able to cope with things the way I used to.
Come on.
It's got to the point, Meg, where every time someone says my name, I jump. This business with Eve Wilder and David, Joyce, Mae Collins, and now Nora Flynn. It's just one disaster after another. And all I can think of is what's going to come next.
We've been through rough patches before. It'll blow over.
Maybe. We just don't seem to get anywhere, though, do we? You bend over backwards trying to be fair to the women, then all it takes is one thing like this for them all to turn against you. Makes you wonder whether Joan Ferguson's got the right idea.
Oh, dear. As bad as that, is it?
No, not really. I am starting to feel it's one step forward and three steps back. I really don't know whether I've got the energy to keep going.
You know what I think? I think we ought to have dinner tonight, just to cheer ourselves up.
Sounds like a good idea. Let's get some takeaway. If I haven't already cracked up by then.
Oh, yeah.
She's probably well clear by now. She couldn't even be interstate.
Oh, that is if Kelly didn't do her in like she reckoned she did.
Oh, I don't believe that. Nora can take care of Kelly.
Want to tell her that?
No.
What are you looking for?
Oh, tissues. My hay fever's playing up again.
In the locker. I didn't know you got hay fever.
Oh, it's only sometimes. I think the smoke at the barbecue got it going.
I haven't got round chucking it out yet, you know.
You don't have to be embarrassed about keeping a photo of your mum. She probably had a really good reason for not coming to see you.
Yeah, sure. Look, we got any coffee or, you know?
No one would blame you for being upset, you know.
Upset? I'm not. Yeah, well, wouldn't you be? I mean, she could have at least made the effort to come and see me once.
Oh, well,
that's the way she feels. I mean, it's fine with me. Who needs a mum anyway? More trouble than they're worth. Look, I'll go grab a toot.
What do you want?
You argued this afternoon with me. In front of everyone. I'm here to show you. You shouldn't have done that.
You know, the time of the year I liked best was Queen's birthday weekend. You never saw so many politicians and business tycoons coming in all at the same time to celebrate their new knighthoods.
I know, same sort of thing with me. Who was that wealthy grazier? Oh, you know the one. Bought himself an MBE.
Oh, yes.
He came in reeking of sheepdags and whiskey. He paid me $1,000 to stay with him all night.
Oh, I ask you, Jessie, how often would that happen nowadays? Maybe we better come out of retirement and see.
Hey, that'd be a giggle, wouldn't it?
Mind you, I bet we could still give some of those young ones a run for their money. Oh, no, Mabel, it's all changed. The customer isn't interested in gentility anymore. It's all handcuffs and whips and coloured TV screens above the bed instead of mirrors. Mm. The profession's lost its innocence, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Still, there's a lot of nice young girls on the game these days. Mm. Yeah. I love it when they call around for a cuppa. We get talking about the old days, no?
Nice to know we're not completely forgotten. Yeah.
Forgotten? You? Don't be silly. You could have been more famous than Tilly Devine, except she had all those dreadful journalist friends to write about her in the papers. You know, you had the best figure in the business in those days.
Yeah, well, it's all history now. We're just a couple of respectable middle-aged ladies who couldn't get arrested if we tried.
Yeah.
If we last out a few more years, they'll probably give us MBEs of our own.
Oh, wouldn't that be a turn-up?
Under the bed, girl.
It's a raid. Hey, might be the Queen with our MBEs.
Yes, dear, what can I do? Oh, my God, it isn't.
I want to talk to you.
I'm sure you do. Come on in, then.
In private?
You never did like Mabel in the old days. Well, she stays. On past record, it would be well to have a witness to whatever you're going to say. How's the kid?
That's why I'm here. I've been saddled with her for long enough. I want her off my back.
Do you indeed?
Yes, I do, and I want you to tell her the truth. That you're her real mother. So, things are now at a stage where I've simply too much to lose if it all comes out. And I'm determined Lexi will know the truth.
My first instincts were always not to trust you. And I only went against them because you were the right person in the right place at the right time.
When we made that agreement, things were totally different.
But it was still an agreement and you broke it.
Oh, that's hardly fair. I looked after that kid till she was 14. I wasn't going to let her spoil my chance of a happy marriage.
A rich marriage, you mean? You dumped a 14-year-old kid and left her to fend for herself. Come on, I want you out of here. And if ever I see you again, I don't care how much of a lady muck you are now. I've still got friends who'll happily run your guts up a flagpole if I don't decide to do it myself.
Forgetting something, aren't you? Who was it that dumped the kid in the first place?
I did not dump her. You agreed to look after her, and you were well paid for the arrangement. You're a conniving bitch. And I'm telling you again, get out of here while you can.
She's your kid. And if you want to see her, she's in Wentworth Detention Centre. Now you just get her off my back.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Could have fooled me, eh?
Oh.
Who did it?
Doesn't matter.
It was Kelly, wasn't it?
Look, don't worry about it, all right?
Is it just the eye?
Oh, my ribs are a bit sore, but I think they'll be all right. Nothing to howl over. I guess with Nora gone and Rita not interested, we're just going to have to take whatever she dishes out. Either that or just do what she says in the first place.
Maybe.
Where are you going?
Gotta go to the toilet.
You've just been.
Yeah, well, all the excitement's getting to me, OK?
Oh, Lexi.
Don't worry. And stay there.
Come on, you can come out now.
Well, get a move on. Unless you want to stay here, of course.
No way. But things to do and people to see.
She promised to keep me posted on how the kid was going.
And instead she ran away to Perth. After she spent all your money, I told you not to trust her.
Yeah, well, she was unhappy in the business, and I agreed to stake her to a new life, provided she took Lexi with her, looked after her properly, and stayed off the streets.
Some hope.
Went straight back on the game, the bitch. Oh, what chance did that kid have? No wonder she landed up in jail. You know, I can't help feeling a bit guilty.
I hope you're not thinking of writing to tell her who you are.
Oh, Mabe, I couldn't handle a kid then. What chance have I got now? It's the last thing I need.
Well, at least you're talking sense for once.
I beg your pardon?
Well, you don't always think things through.
Oh, rubbish.
Well, you never did. Well, trust you to get clucky at 40.
Didn't have much time left, so...
Well, you don't even know who her father is, and that's the first thing she's going to ask.
I picked three of my favourite clients. There was a high-up politician, a champion tennis player,
and that famous writer chappie.
Of course, they didn't know. I just stopped taking precautions every time they visited me. One of them's Lexi's father, but even I don't know which one.
Oh, Lexi's going to love that, isn't she? Your father was great with a racket, but I can't remember his name.
I figured she'd turn out either healthy, cunning, or clever, depending on which one hit the jackpot.
The whole idea was a mistake, looking after a baby at your age.
Yeah. And Lexi bawled day in, day out. I had a business to run. I mean, I went into administration when I was pregnant, never went back on the other.
Too much like hard work.
I wanted to spend time with the kid, but I got so as I couldn't stand the sight of her.
Your own child?
That's got nothing to do with it. Some kids I like, some kids I don't. This one I didn't. Still, it'd be interesting to have a look at her now.
And how are you going to do that? She's in prison.
Well, it wouldn't be hard. Just pay her a visit. Might be worth a look. Just out of curiosity.
Jessie.
Well, just out of curiosity. Just to see how she's turned out.
Quit following me around, will you? You'll get your money when I'm ready to give it to you.
It ain't about the money.
What are you getting so steamed up about? Just all you care about these days, ain't it?
Look, just keep away from Julie.
Don't tell me Lurch really hurt her.
You know she bloody well did. And so did you.
Well, if she gets in my way again, she'll get a lot worse. One more squeak out of
just
that
little... Just keep away from her!
You're not getting the message, are you?
Oh, yeah, I'm getting the message all right.
Well, there's nothing you can do about it as long as I'm top dog.
That's going to be for a long time. I'll make you a deal.
I don't need to deal with you.
About the $100.
What about it?
You can keep it, so long as you stay away from Julie.
Mm, generous, aren't we? Well, you two on together or something?
Is it a deal?
What are you two up to?
Nothing, Mrs. Slattery.
Well, don't hang around in the corridors.
Righto. $100, eh? Okay, it's a deal.
You try ripping me off. I'm going to tell Connors who really did a jacket over.
Yeah? Well, you do that, and the first thing I'll do is kill your little friend. What do you want?
Just came to check you're okay. What's it to you?
Come on. Bloody shame about your jacket, eh? Reckon the freak will cop it one day, though, eh?
I've got a long memory, Kelly. Remember that.
Yeah.
Now, rack off. I've got some figuring to do.
Sure. See you later.
Feeling better?
You didn't try anything with Kelly, did you?
Just had a little chat.
Oh, Lex, you shouldn't have. She starts on you.
I said chat! Now, come on, Wimp, pull yourself together. I've got my own problems to worry about, you know.
You must be sick of having to stick up for me all the time.
Yeah, yeah. Put a sock in it, will you?
I don't know what I'd do if I didn't have you to talk to. You're my best friend.
Well, don't rely on it, eh? I take care of number one, don't I?
Yeah, I know.
Well, there's our top dog. After that pathetic act at lunchtime, I think I'll have Egbert arrange things from now on.
Don't worry, she's been taken care of.
Too late. A real top dog would have taken care of Egbert before she wrecked everything, not after.
Oh, you want to see what a real top dog can do? Well, it just so happens I've set something up that'll show everyone once and for all who's running things around here.
Oh, you have you? And what is it?
You want to see? Just be in the dining room tonight.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known.
the rose.